Hey, this is Kev with Blender Binge. In this video, we're going to be talking about moving the object origin, which is this little orange dot. It's just very useful to begin with rigging and a whole bunch of other stuff that you'd want to do in Blender, and it's really, really useful. Might not be the most exciting thing, but trust me, you're going to want to know this at some point, so might as well learn it now. Ready? Let's go. Now this video is sort of a follow-on to the video that I did earlier in one of the alpha builds of Blender. And now that it's more of a solid build in the beta here, or going forward into 2.8, I want to talk about this and show you how to do it. So really quickly, in order to move this little orange dot, all you have to do now, and this is probably the fastest way I've found, is you can use this little cursor button up here. And if you now left click and drag around, you see it dragging. And it kind of drags all over the place, right? So wherever it lands, you can set that as your object origin. But you probably don't want to do that. You probably want to have it snap to an edge or to a vertex. So in order to do that, we can turn on snapping up here, this little kind of ruler thingy. And you can say, let's say vertex, right? And we'll leave the rest of this alone. And now if you're still left clicking and dragging, but if you hold down the Alt key while you do this, it will snap to the vertices, right? Same thing where is if you go to edges, right? And you click and drag and you hold down Alt, it'll snap and it will follow along those edges within reason. If you pull too far away, it snaps out. But as you move forward, see it snaps back, it just snaps. And you can position this anywhere you want it. So this is a really quick way in doing that. Same thing with faces. You can go face up here, all right? And you drag and you hold down Alt and it will snap to the faces. All right, hold down Alt and you're on a face, it's on the face. And now all you have to do to move this little guy is go Object, Set Origin, Origin to 3D Cursor, and that little thing moves. Now the nice thing with this is once you position the origin of the object, you can center that 3D cursor again. So I'm just hitting Shift S and then I go cursor to world origin, right? And if I go on this rotate tab now, the little tool, you'll see that it holds, okay? Your object is there, okay? Really quick way of doing this and positioning. Now, if you want that to just kind of snap to the middle, okay, the best way to do that is going to hit tab, and you could say face, right? And I'll select this face. I will say Shift S, okay, cursor to selected. That puts it right in the middle of that selection, that selected face. Hit tab, and now I could just say object, set origin, and I can say origin to 3D cursor, and now it's dead center in the middle of that face. And it works the same way with edges too. So for instance, if I hit tab, last one I'm gonna do, I select the edge, all right? I want it to snap to the middle of this. I just hit Shift S, I say cursor to selected, puts it right in the dead center of that. Now when I hit tab, go back out to object mode, I go to object, set origin, and I can say origin to 3D cursor, and now it locks there and it rotates from here. All right, so if you were to go ahead and center your cursor or hide the cursor again, right, cursor to world origin, and you select this object again, your object is centered right there. And again, you could kind of change cursor or view or gimbal, global, local, any of these. You could see the transform orientations, or you could go 3D cursor and you can always rotate around the 3D cursor again, but then you can always change it back to active element and that'll snap it back to that pivot point, to that object origin point that you'd set. So hopefully that makes sense. Really short video, but this is really, if you start understanding how this works, this is the precursor to a lot of stuff that we're gonna do later with rigging. So you probably want to get this stuff kind of in your head, or at least have a rudimentary understanding of it. So hopefully you got something out of this short video. If you did, hit like, subscribe, hit that little bell notification, because I'm going to keep making more of these, and I will talk to you in the next video. Thanks. Bye.